you and Sky Blue have returned to Ireland.
That's right.
You were here during the summer, and you just can't seem to keep away. What is it? What's brought you back so soon?
You know, we have Irish in our blood.
Really?
You know, yeah. Gordy is we're descendants. And so, you know, we like to party. Champagne showers,
popping in the club, light it up, 8 hours. Now, I have a very serious question to ask you.
Right, okay. 12.
What? Oh, Lord. Okay. What is party rock?
Party rock is a verb. You know, to party rock means to be the life of the party, be the life of wherever you're at.
Okay.
If you're at your job, you can party rock at your job, you know, by, you know, being the, you know, the courageous, the kind of the clown. You know, when you were in school, you could party rock by just being the funny guy, but you know, it's
you
like
you can party rock anywhere.
Yeah. It's just it's that person that just has that
je
energy.
Ne sais quoi.
Yeah. Party rock is in the house tonight.
Everybody just have a good time. Hot seat questions to get into the mind of Red Foo, right? So don't think about it. Mm-hmm. Just fire them out. Okay, here we go. If you were king of the world for a day, what rules would you introduce?
Oh man. You know, King Fred, this is a good question.
I'm gonna go back, sit back, and think about this one for a while.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
What?
Good point. I would change all of the street signs.
Okay.
With the little walking man.
Yeah.
Into a shuffling man.
That would be amazing. That
so
would
that
be
you
brilliant.
Would shuffle across the street because it's faster.
That's walking true.
Is just, you know, you're slowing up everybody. Just let's
it's more
shuffle
efficient.
Along. Shuffle it along. Every day I'm shuffling.
What is love?
Love is a verb.
That's probably the most literal answer we've ever got on that show. Red Foo, thank you so much for taking time to chill with us, man. Really, really appreciate it.
To love.
To love. Always.
Or still not to love. That is the question. It's a verb. Wow. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that
body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Fight like apes. Cornish Tashiv.
Tom Megama.
Tommy Onewa. I remember it was colored in
green. Filth and rubbish. When was the last time you played in Ireland? Was it recently or was it a while ago? Or?
Slain. Yeah, we headlined Slain this year.
And we headlined the Junction Festival Clonmel last year.
Headlined
last
Junction
weekend.
Festival.
Well, you know,
Clonmel,
that's a step
Slain,
up from Slain, in fairness. Headlined you know.
Them as well. I've just Slain directly.
Festival.
After
we
Slain.
Actually remain supported at Bandon Festival. He's dead, he's high on
meds, he's still in bed. I can't tell if this is a ruse or not.
No, we did Slain, man. We did Slain.
Headline Slain.
That Mount lad rang us up there.
You can't tell
Charlie.
If this is a joke.
Charlo.
We just told you headline
Charlie
Slain.
Rang us up there.
That was a joke, but then it kind of entered the realms of possibility, like with the other gigs. But okay, no, that's fine. We're all up for a joke here.
All right.
It's grand. I'm with it. I'm with it. White Like Apes, thanks a million for chatting to us.
Thank you very much.
I'll try to catch your set if I'm not cooped up in here.
Please.
Nobody told us you couldn't catch
it. I'm going to try. I'm going to try for you guys because, you know, I don't want you to end up holding me in the same regard you hold Owen.
Yeah, that's fair. No.
Yeah. I want to try and keep it, you know.
It's not us, it's just Jamie hating.
It's just you.
Who?
Right. Slán, fight like ace.
Slán, lads, agus fíor a mhaith.
Well, to main shuss and 0-2, let McFly, lads, cunas tashiv.
Guma.
Into. Fantastic. Well, you are in the 0-2 for your gig tonight, so how's it sounding?
It's all sounding good. Soundcheck went really well.
Yeah.
It's our first time that we've ever you know, played here as one of our own shows. So it should be good fun.
How's the tour going so far?
Brilliant, yeah, it's going great. My knees are quite scabby. I can't show you my jeans.
Skinny jeans.
But yeah, I slid on my knees at Wembley.
Well, he says it's from sliding on his knees at Wembley, but I've got my suspicions.
I've also heard kind of rumours, kind of twitterings, various things about a new album in the works.
The majority of this year is just going to be touring. And then maybe towards the end of this year, we'll go and record it somewhere, or early next year.
All right.
If an album is a band's baby, then we're just at the foreplay section at the moment.
Right, guys, thanks a million for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
Really genuinely appreciate it.
No, it's been great.
Would you like to say goodbye to your Irish fans? I believe you have a message for them.
Slán.
Oh, spoken like a pro. Check that out. Oh, you ladies were practicing your Irish, actually, before we started rolling, weren't you?
Yeah, Deirdre's from Glasgow, Bury.
Deirdre's from Glasgow, Bury.
Great, and Doris, and Oscar and Finjog.
Profound, I think. Profound. The Rubber Bandits, lads.
Conor Sulhan.
To me, Mishigma, yeah, to Mishigma. Oh, baby, you're so beautiful.
I wanna be your man. Man fair. We're doing the Tan of Assen Festival, yeah?
Shut up.
Sorry, Captain Shake will make kind of me all
on. Oh, Neil Gaelge again.
Neil Gaelge again. I'm just explaining.
Well, no, you're not. You're slagging me in front of him.
Captain Shake will make kind of me all on our Lomshaw Gaelge.
Well, so we're going to do the interview.
You were talking about saying, you know, he can't grow a beard.
No, I wasn't saying
he
that.
He can't grow a beard.
Well, you can't, all right?
It doesn't matter. Don't start saying it in Irish in front when I'm not even around. Like.
Hey, it's all good. Not everyone.
You're my best friend.
Not everyone at auction has
You're
a beard.
My best friend.
We just did it.
Why would I do that?
We just did it.
Do it in English. Why would I do it in Irish?
You don't do it in English when I'm not around.
Lads, I hate to think
we just did it.
We just Daft Punk have this problem.
Yeah, I do. Yeah. All right.
This is going to put a strain on the friendship now.
Oh, we'll be grand.
I hope you will.
We had the same problem with Dutch TV when he started talking about my shins, and I let it go.
Yeah. And what was that? Only a shit? It was only a slight joke about your shins. It wasn't anything personal.
Well, look.
To be fair now,
we didn't actually say anything about you at all.
I don't
really.
Because I float just like a butterfly.
I sting just like a baby. Ham sandwich. Yay! Yeah, at least it made a sound this time. Yeah, that's the word. Okay, great. We know what you're doing for New Year's. Any plans for Christmas?
Just relaxing. Well, we're playing Kells as well, actually.
I'm going to cook a duck.
You're going to cook a duck?
Yeah.
Slightly unorthodox.
I don't know how, but I'm going to do it.
You're going to Beats, fast, colours and promises. So, Tom, I'm just in Olympia in Malia Arclea, and I am with Christina Perry. Christina, come to talk to.
Ah, goma.
Like a pro. Like a boss. And who do you think you are? Running around, leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts. One thing I have to get out of the way before we start this review proper, I am actually physically intimidated by how beautiful you are.
Shall we hug? Let's hug.
Oh, that is a defining moment of my life. Darling, don't be afraid. I loved you. So, we were talking earlier. This is your first time playing in Ireland.
Yes.
Are you excited, nervous? What's the feeling?
Oh, my gosh. The vibe today is unreal because not only is it my first time playing in Ireland, but it's also the last night of our tour. So with that comes, you know, silliness and everybody is so excited. We've had the best time ever, but the last show is always, you know, magical.
Yeah.
And so it's already setting up to be my favorite show. And also, you know, the fans here, I'm so honored to have gone from a smaller venue to a bigger venue so quickly. Like, it's my first time. Like, it just doesn't make sense. Like, this is so bananas. So I'm, like, beyond giddy and excited. And, like, this big smile of mine, like, is definitely going to walk out on stage like, didn't took so long just
to feel. Let's talk about Love Strong a little bit, because it came out earlier in the year. And I've heard a lot of people describe it as a breakup album. Now, I listened to it. I didn't get a vibe that specific from it personally.
Sweet.
But what was the theme running throughout the album in your own words?
Well, basically, Love Strong being my debut album is, you know, my firstborn children is what I call them. They're like, when someone makes their first album, it's the songs that they like can't imagine their first album not having.
Yeah.
And so for me, some of those songs I wrote when I was 15, and all the way up, I'm 25 now. So they're the past 10 years of my life. And unfortunately or unfortunately, I fall in and out of love a lot. And so that's the theme, because that's what I write about. Love inspires me the most, and the feelings that go along with being in love. So where I could see it being a breakup album is because I've obviously broken up with all the dudes I've been with because I'm not married. But right. It has that low, but it definitely, there's high points in the album also. And so if you look at it as a whole, I would hope that you take from it just the journey of the heart, not so much specific relationships. Yeah. It's just the ups and downs and all the things that go along with love.
Thanks so much for sitting and chatting with
Thank
us.
Thank you, man. And are you staying for the show?
I'll be sticking around for the show.
Okay,
of
great.
For the world. I wish you all success in the world.
Oh, thank
and,
you.
And we'll see you again soon.
Awesome. Thank you. Who do you think you are? Running around, leaving
scars, collecting your jar of hearts. So, Shinny and Shin, Christina Perry, Colleen, Fear, Yas, August, Fear, Dahul, Toshe, Duck, Kretcha, Keiko, Dahulis, Ata, on Colleen, Shin.